They're Hong Kong's most high-profile democracy campaigners, all now facing either prison or suspended jail terms handed down by the territory's highest court. Their crime, defying police orders and taking part in pro-democracy rallies in August 2019, which is illegal under a controversial national security law.
Hey, good morning, everybody. This is a very, very nice day in Hong Kong today.
Billionaire media mogul Jimmy Lai was sentenced to 14 months in prison. He recently spoke to the BBC about the case.
Fear is the most inexpensive and convenient way of ruling people and controlling people. You know, if they can induce fear in you, that's the easiest way to control you. That's the cheapest way to control you and the most effective way. And they know it, and they're very, you know, they're very good at it.
By chance, today in Hong Kong, events had been organized to celebrate the very security laws that have led to the activists being imprisoned. Concerns are only growing about the erosion of democracy as China asserts itself more in Hong Kong.
I hope it's not irreversible, but it certainly looks that way. There's no indication at all that Chairman Xi is going to reverse his repression of individual rights in Hong Kong and therefore to allow people to express their views either simply by talking or writing, as Jimmy Lai did, or indeed through the ballot box. So, you know, this is a major attack on individual liberty in Hong Kong.
We contacted the Chinese embassy in London, who told us China upholds the rule of law. Hong Kong is a society under the rule of law. The legal proceedings instituted against Jimmy Lai and some other anti-China elements aiming at destabilizing Hong Kong for suspicion of undermining China's national security in collusion with foreign or external forces are lawful steps. Hong Kong is part of China. Hong Kong's affairs are purely China's internal affairs and brook no interference by any foreign country in any form. Of course, Britain does have a stake in this. In the agreement that led to Hong Kong's handover in 1997, China promised not to change the territory's political, economic, and social systems for 50 years. Beijing has clearly grown impatient with that, but what can stop China now?
Ellie McBull there. You can see more of Jimmy Lai's story on Our World this weekend on the BBC News Channel. Now I'm joined by Nathan Laura, pro-democracy activist from Hong Kong, and from Beijing, Victor Gao, Vice President for the Centre for China and Globalisation. Nathan Laura, let's start with you.
Sure.
Clearly these are pretty serious sentences and convictions. Were they unexpected? Where does your movement go from here?
The convictions are definitely appalling. People did not expect that, given that that rally was a peaceful one. But all these organizers and participants are sentenced to 12 to 18 months. That is a severe sentencing. And many of us think that this is definitely a political motivated charge, and that really harms Hong Kong as, showing that the judicial system is compromised. They're being seen and used as a legal weapon to prosecute democratic activists.
So you feel that you and your movement's being silenced?
Well, definitely. If you look at 1.7 million participants in that rally and their voice being eliminated, and for the people who participated, they have suffered from this harsh sentencing, it's definitely not a signal for the respect of the right of protest of Hong Kong people.
Victor Gao, how can it be justified that pensioners, 60s, 70s, 80-something-year-olds, peacefully protesting, can be thrown in jail?
Well, first of all, allow me to say that Mr. Nathan Lau in front of you is not a pro-democracy activist. He's a fugitive from the law of Hong Kong. And if he goes back, he will be prosecuted and most likely he will be convicted too. Now, he talked about demonstrations or protests peaceful. Use your own eye to see where is the peacefulness of the demonstrations. There was violence everywhere in the streets of Hong Kong. There was a storming of the electrical building. There was disruption of social order in Hong Kong. If you call that peaceful demonstration, you are losing your mind. You are losing your sight. you are losing your wisdom. What happened in Hong Kong could be compared with the storming of the U.S. Capitol on January the 6th, and the U.S. government has rightfully labeled that as domestic terrorism. Nathan,
well, just hang on a minute there, Vitor Gao. You're throwing all sorts of accusations around there, but the comparison there was there were protesters that invaded the Capitol and tried to overthrow an election. You are comparing that to 70-something, 80-something-year-old barristers and legislators, elected legislators, who have just been thrown in jail, and they certainly haven't been accused of doing any violence whatsoever.
No, I think what they have been convicted under was not under the national security law. They have been convicted under existing laws in Hong Kong. They may be charged by the national security law separately, but that's another matter. Now, you may know for sure, you may know better than I do, Hong Kong has deeply rooted traditions of rule of law, many of which were actually left by the British before they left Hong Kong in 1997. Now, Hong Kong should promote greater democracy. There is no doubt about it. Democracy everywhere in the world could be better improved and better promoted.
Well, not by but throwing people in jail for having a protest.
No, you cannot do violence. You cannot do illegal, unlawful demonstrations in Hong Kong. And this is true today. This was true under the British in 1997 and before.
You can't blame the British for this. Promises were made in 1997 that for 50 years, Hong Kongers would live under the same social and economic settlement. Where is that promise, that one country, two systems?
Exactly.
It's gone now, isn't it?
You mentioned whether one country, two system is dead. Let me assure you, one country, two system is live and thriving, and it will be continued up to 2047. And if the situation prevails, it may even be extended beyond 2047. Anyone who believes that one country, two system is dead in Hong Kong, again, you are indulging your own imagination. Hong Kong people do not need to fear about arson, anarchy, violence. That's the fear that troubles everyone in Hong Kong. Well, and democracy, if you want to promote democracy, use peaceful means rather than commit violence or incite violence.
I'm really showing my manner to respect the program, but obviously Mr. Gao's comment is extremely childish. He tries to attack me for being labeled as a fugitive under the national security law, which all the international community recognize as the intrusion of our human rights and damaging our rule of law, basically. And for us, we are being silenced under the national security law. Our freedom of speech, freedom of assembly, or even personal safety are being compromised. So that is the reason why I am granted asylum in the UK. So Mr. Gao is basically attacking the whole UK asylum system. And secondly, Mr. Gao has no knowledge about what's happening today in the courts, given that the judge and the prosecution, they have all agreed the nature of the August 18th protest is peaceful. It's all listed at the agreed facts. And the reason why they are charged with an authorized assembly instead of unlawful assembly and rioting is because the protest is completely peaceful. So Mr. Gao has no knowledge on the case. And he's trying to confuse all of us, saying that, oh, that was violence. It is not. And the fact that people are being jailed for 18 months of merely participating in a peaceful assembly is what went wrong.
So do you think the British government is doing enough, or the Western governments generally? You see today Chairman Xi, climate change talks with European leaders. He's been invited to see Joe Biden as well. I mean, is it possible to separate out these issues like having to deal with China over climate change? What do you expect from the UK?
Well, definitely, I think there should be a unity and alliance formed by democratic countries, especially if you can really see how aggressive China is behaving. And with mouthpiece like Mr. Gao, they have been confusing all the facts and trying to do their propaganda, even on this very reputable show, and trying to flame me and smear me in front of the UK audience. And you can really see that how aggressive they are. And I think on this particular case, first of all, the UK government should really consider to pull off they're judges from Hong Kong. This is a really strong...
Pull judges from... So yes. For people that don't know, there are British judges who were sent over to Hong Kong, goes back decades, and that's continuing. You want that to stop?
I think that should be one of the considerations. And secondly, put Hong Kong officials who are responsible for the human rights violation in Hong Kong into the sanction list. I think these are really effective to send a very strong signal.
Victor Gao, what would happen if the UK started sanctioning Beijing over the issue of what was going on in Hong Kong?
China has made it very clear. China is not to be pushed around. If the British government wants to push China without justification, China will push back. And if UK wants to impose sanctions on China, China will strike back. This is a world of equal sovereignties. And if the UK government want to sanction what's happening in Hong Kong, please allow Mr. Nathan Lau in front of you to do what he did in Hong Kong in the United Kingdom. He will be prosecuted. He will be sent to jail because he is not promoting peaceful demonstrations. And those people in Hong Kong who are convicted are inciting violence. They are disrupting social order.
But Mr. Gao, people are voting with their feet. Thousands of Hong Kongers are taking advantage of the British overseas passport and are applying to come to the United Kingdom to escape the anti-freedom reforms that are being made in Hong Kong at the behest of Beijing.
Listen to me. I interpreted for Deng Xiaoping in the 1980s. You may remember when President Reagan came to visit Mr. Deng Xiaoping in Beijing, Reagan suggested that Chinese government should not block the immigration rights of the Chinese people. Do you know what did Deng Xiaoping said to President Reagan? He said, are you serious? If you really want to take Chinese immigrants, I can allow 30 million Chinese immigrants to go to the United States. Do you really want to take them? That's the end of the story as far as between China and the United States are concerned. Now, on any given day, there are lots of people in Hong Kong, in mainland China, who may want to emigrate to the United Kingdom. That's a fact. Do you really think you want to take all the immigrants from Hong Kong or from mainland China to the United Kingdom? If you are serious about that...
I think we have a serious problem here. Mr. Gao is spreading misinformation. He's omitting the fact that on this particular case, all sides agree that it was a peaceful demonstration and there was no violence emerged.
Nathan,
so I really want to stress that no misinformation campaign should be allowed in this show.
And secondly,
you can really see that he's out of his manner.
Where is the peacefulness or the violence?
Just a minute, Mr. Gao.
We need to make sure that, guests that's being invited to the show has a simple manner.
Yeah.
Just try to control themselves and let each other speak, as I do. And for me, if we really look at what's happening in Hong Kong, and I think after imposition of the national security law, the UK government has said very clearly, the Chinese government breached the Sino-British Joint Declaration, which the UK government has an obligation to oversee its implementation for multiple times, including imposing the national security law. So it is definitely on, UK government's obligation to do it.
Well, we must leave it there. Thank you very much for joining us here in the studio, Nathan Law. And thank you for joining us, Victor Gao from Beijing. Much appreciated. Thank you
for having me.
Thank you so much.